40 Thieves, our horn section. And a gruesome lot they are, too, ladies and gentlemen.
So fine.
36, 22, 36.
Eyes on, hands off, 'cause she's mine, all mine. My baby, she looks so good.
36, 22, 36.
I know you would steal her if you only could.
Johnny, tell us what you think. 36, 22, 36.
Looks so good from her head to her feet.
36, 22, 36.
My girl can be tired, but she can't be beat. baby, she looks so fine.
36, 22, 36.
Eyes on, hands off, 'cause she's mine, all mine.
36, 22, 36.
My baby, she looks so fine.
36, 22, 36.
Eyes on, hands off, 'cause she's mine, all mine.
There's still lots to drink, ladies and gentlemen, if you're thirsty. You don't know how much it's going to cost to buy your steel-belted radials back yet, so why don't you all just cooperate? And we won't open the gas fumes. How's that sound? Demonic repossession. It's a tune about something that many of the people in this room are intimately familiar with. It's a song entitled Big Brass Bed. Well, I came home last night. I opened up my door. All I found in my bedroom was the linoleum on the floor. Started me to rim. And I know all my bills are due. Now, I knew I owed the Iceman the lights, the water, and the gas. But they shouldn't have taken my bed when I bought that bed. I know I paid cash. It keeps me warm. And I know all my bills are due. Big brass bed is gone, but who did I owe my baby to? And I don't know what to do. So little and tiny, sleeps with the covers up over her head. There's only one thing bothering me. She's still in that big brass bed. I'm gonna get myself a job with the city hauling trash, so I can look in every house and find out where they've got my baby stashed. My big brass bed is gone, but who did I owe my baby to?
Oh,
Junior Dean on tenor.
When I got me the strangest woman, believe me, this chick's no cinch. But I really get her going when I pull out my big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues. Yes, the band that plays the blues. She just loved my big 10-inch record of favorite blues. Tease her, I gave her a little pinch, and she said, stop your chaffing and pull out your big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues. Yes, the band that plays the blues. She just loved my big 10-inch record of her favorite blues. Now I cover her with kisses when we're in a lover's clinch, and when she gets all excited, well, she breaks my big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues. Yes, the band that plays the blues. She just loved my big 10-inch record of her favorite blues. Makes her flinch. Seems she really don't go for nothing except my big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues. Yes, the band that plays the blues. She just loved my big 10-inch record of her favorite blues.
There comes a time in everybody's life when you leave the mortal coil, when you pass on to some greater world that lies beyond that which we presently comprehend as the limits of consciousness, which is where I spend most of my time. And I'd like you to know that it's not as much fun as it is here, so stay cool. When that time comes, you've got to be prepared, and there are some things that you should do in order to keep yourself on top of the situation as you are presently finding it. You've got to get in touch with your doctor, you've got to get in touch with your lawyer, you've got to get in touch with your real estate agent, your broker, your bank manager, but most importantly of all, you have to get in touch with the undertaker, because the undertaker is the man who's going to see to it that you go out in style, that you go out with a measure of class, that you go out with grace and aplomb, because he's the man who's going to fit you out for your lavender coffin.
coffin with white gardenias all the way around. A swing band playing the funeral march when they blow me into the holy ground. All I want is a row of sweet maidens looking their best cause they're all dressed in white. Swinging around my lavender coffin and throwing the mourners a real tight night.
St. Peter!
Yes, I'm coming.
St. Peter!
Lord, I'm coming today.
St. Peter!
Yes, I'm coming. And open up the gates on my judgment day. Hear them angels solemnly swinging and Gabriel blowing the funeral sound. All I want is a lavender coffin when they lower me into the holy ground. I've wasted every night now, ladies and gentlemen. Drinking right on through to the dawn. And now just like my very last bottle, I want you to know my time has just about come. I've wasted my life playing dice in the horses from Greenwood Racetrack to Timbuktu. And now that I'm running my last mile, people, please help me make my last wish come true. All I want is a lavender coffin to rest in peace after a life of sin. And when I get in my lavender coffin, it'll be my first sleep since God knows when.
Hey, Peter!
Yes, I'm coming. Lord, I'm coming today. Here come the job bombers and open up the gates on my judgment day. Blow.
Ladies and gentlemen, I was called here this evening to demonstrate this, to talk about this sport coat, which shocks John.
As I was walking down the street last night, a pretty little girl came into sight. I bowed and smiled and asked her her name. She said, "Hold on, Jack, I don't play that game." I reached my pocket and to her big surprise, there's Abraham Lincoln standing straight in the eyes on a greenback. Greenback down the bill. It's just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll. She looked at me with that familiar desire. My eyes lit up like they was on fire. She said, "My name's Flo, you're on the right track. But listen here, buddy, I wear furs on my back. If you want to get along in this man's land, let's see Lincoln and Jackson start shaking hands on a greenback. Greenback on the bill. It's just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll." I didn't know what I was getting into, but I popped Lincoln and I popped Jackson too. I didn't mind seeing them fading out of sight. Knew I was gonna have some fun that night. Whenever you're in town, you're looking for a thrill. If Lincoln won't get it for you, Jackson sure will. On a greenback, greenback dollar bill. It's just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll. Del Dago and Barrett Cone. Thank you. went to a night spot. The lights were down low. We dined and danced and I was ready to go. I got out of my seat and when Flo arose, she said, hold on, Daddy, while I powder my nose. I sat back down with a smile on my face. Well, she went down to the powder place with my greenbacks. Greenback dollar bill. It's just a little piece of paper coated with a chlorophyll. The music stopped and the lights came on. I looked around and saw I was all alone. I didn't know how long Flo had been gone, but her nose powder sure didn't take that long. I left the place with tears in my eyes. I was like Lincoln and Jackson, a final goodbye on a greenback dollar bill. It's just a little piece of paper coated with a chlorophyll. Greenback dollar bill. Thank you very much. The one and only Lamb Chop Loomer on guitar, ladies and gentlemen. Incidentally, we would like very much to offer you all the opportunity to go into the control booth and stay there forever. No. We will be releasing nitrous oxide from all the air vents in the building. And I think the bar still has some draft beer spritzers left, for those of you of an economic bent. This is a tune about teen job talk. Gentlemen, get me out of here.
One, two, three.
Oh. Hey, Bobbery
Bob.
Hey, Bobbery Bob.
Hey, Bobbery Bob.
Hey, Bobbery Bob. Yes, young daddy, no. Well, Matilda Brown told old King Tut, if you can't say rebop, keep your big mouth shut. Hey, Bob-a-rebop.
Hey, Bob-a-rebop.
Hey, Bob-a-rebop.
Hey, Bob-a-rebop.
Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Yes, young daddy, no. Well, Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Jill come down with a $5 bill.
What? No water.
Hey,
Bob-a-rebop.
Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Yes, young daddy, no. Papa's on the cot and your baby's on the floor blowing his natural pipe. Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Yes, young daddy, no. You ain't never gonna get it. Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Hey, Bob-a-rebop. Yes, young daddy knows. One last chance for the horn.
ladies and gentlemen, at the top of the Ambassador Hotel in Chicago, Illinois. My name is Dave Flexingbergstein, and I'm here to entertain you with some low-key poetic drivel for a couple hours. I hope you'll all drink yourselves into a coma. Down to my last pair of shoes, I can't even win a nickel bet. 'Cause of them that got, Lord, it's them that gets. And I ain't got nothing yet. Well, I'm sneaking in and out on my poor old landlord. All I seem to do is stay in bed. 'Cause of them that got, Lord, it's them that gets. And I ain't got nothing yet. That old expression, them that got is them as gets, is something I simply cannot see. If you've got to have something before you can get something, how you get your first's a mystery. When I see folks around in long cars and fine clothes, that's why they're called the smarter set. 'Cause they manage to get when only them that got supposed to get. Lord, I ain't got nothing yet. That old expression, them as got is them as gets, is something I simply cannot see. If you've got to have something before you can get something, how you get your first's a mystery. When I see folks around in long cars and fine clothes, and that's why they're called the smarter set. 'Cause they manage to get when only them that got supposed to get. Lord, I ain't got nothing yet. I swear I ain't got nothing yet. Oh, well, I ain't got nothing yet. Oh, I
ain't got nothing yet. Oh, I ain't got nothing yet.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Ethel Merman of the alto saxophone, Mr. Del Daco. Theme for Coleman Hawkins. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to get filthy again now. Hey, hubba hubba. This is the song that made it impossible for us to play the 1980 Shucks Johnson Goodwill Tour of the Persian Gulf.
I want a bow-legged woman, that's all. I want a bow-legged woman that's tall. I'll fall in love with her right from the start, because her big fat legs are so far apart. I want a bow-legged woman right now. I gotta find me a girl somehow. She's gotta be built like an old-faced fiddle, great big legs and plenty room in the middle. I got to be on my way to find a bow-legged woman today. Yeah.
He wants a bow-legged woman.
Boy, I'll fall in love with her right from the start, because her big fat legs are so far apart.
He wants a bow-legged woman.
Divine. A bow-legged woman, that's fine. She don't have to be no glamour girl. She gotta have who's like an old beer barrel. Got to be on my way to find a bow-legged woman today. Right in the saddle, you couldn't hear a rattle, and there was nobody there to run and tattle. Got to be on my way to find my bow-legged woman today. I mean, my woman with the big bow legs.
Thank you.